chance than starting over.
What?
You completed your homework the day before it was due, as I have.
What?
Or if you left your wallet at home, you have to go back. You're spending an hour in the casino. You won some money at the casino, and you put all your winnings on red, but it came up black. If you got your blue shirt dry cleaned before the wedding, and then you dropped your boot on it. If you won an argument with a friend, and then later discovered that they just returned to their original parents. Starting over is harder than starting up. If you're not ready for that, like if you've already had a bad day, and what you're about to go through might be too much, feel free to go away and come back. I'll be here. Thanks for coming with me on this trip. I'll understand if you have to take a break at any point. Just find a safe place to stop and quit the game.
Don't worry.
I'll save your progress, always. Even in mistakes.
What?
This game is a homage to a free game that came out in 2000. Sexy Home. The author of that game is Jasmine, a mysterious Czech designer who's known at the time as the father of B-games. B-games are rough assemblages of metal objects. Designers slap them together very quickly and freely, and they're often too rough and unfriendly to gamer to evolve. In a certain way, sexy hiking is the perfect embodiment of a B-game. It's built almost entirely out of found and recycled parts, and it's one of the most unusual and unfriendly games of its time. In it, your task is simply to drag yourself up a mountain with a hammer. That act of climbing, in the digital world or in real life, has certain essential properties that give the game its flavor. No amount of forward progress is guaranteed. Some cliffs are too sheer or too slippery. And the player is constantly, unremittingly in danger of falling and losing everything. Anyway, when you start sexy hiking, you're standing next to this dead tree that blocks the way to the entire rest of the game. It might take you an hour to get over that tree, but what you never do is prod and poke at it, exploring the limits of your reach, trying to find a way up and over. There's a sense of truth in that lack of confidence. Most obstacles in video game worlds are fake, or can be completely different in your ability to get through them, either with the correct method, or the correct equipment, just by spending enough time. In that sense, every pixelated obstacle in sexy hiking is real. Obstacles in sexy hiking are real then, and that makes the game unique. But I'm not sure Jazuo intended to make it. Frustration is just essential to that act of climbing, and it's authentic to the process of building a game about climbing. A funny thing happened to me as I was building this mountain. I'd have an idea for a new obstacle, build it, test it, and it would usually turn out to be unreasonably hard. But I couldn't bring myself to make it easier. I felt like my inability to get past the new obstacle was my fault as a player rather than as a builder. Imagine if mountains built themselves from our efforts to climb. It's our repeated attempts to reach the summit that turns those mountains into scorpion. When you're building a video game world, you're building with ideas. And that can be like working with quickset cement. You mold your ideas into a certain shape, like you play with. And in the process of playing with them, they begin to harden and set until they're immutable, like rock. And at that point, you can't change the world. Not without breaking it into pieces, starting fresh with new ideas. For years now, people have been predicting that games would soon be made out of prefabricated objects, bought in a store and assembled into a world. For the most part, that hasn't happened, because the objects in the stores are trash. I don't mean they look bad, but they're badly made, and a lot of them are. I mean, they're trash in the way that food becomes trash as soon as you put it in the sink. Things are made to be consumed and used in a certain context. And once the moment is gone, it transforms into garbage. In the context of technology, those moments pass by in seconds. Over time, we've poured more and more refuge into this vast digital landfill that we call the internet. In our past, in our numbers, in our ways that things are trash. Everything around us is cultural trash. Trash becomes the whoop. You can build culture out of trash. But only trash culture. B games, B movies, B music, B philosophy.